do, how you do, how you do. It's in alignment with what God says. It's in alignment with the kingdom of God. It's flowing out of the Spirit of God that is on the inside of you. It's flowing out of righteousness. It's flowing out of making peace. It's flowing out of the joy of the Lord that is your strength. It's flowing from these characteristics that comes from the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. That's where it's flowing from. And when you're living your life from that place, God is saying, hey, you are acceptable to me. Oh, hallelujah to God. Anybody want to be acceptable to God? Come on, somebody. Anybody want to make sure that at the end of the day, God is going to say, well done, good and faithful servant. Well done, good and faithful son, my child. You know, come into the kingdom that was prepared for you. Come on, I'm talking to somebody. Yeah, when you do it in alignment with what is acceptable to God, when you do it in alignment with what is acceptable to God, which is living your life from the Spirit of God, which is the kingdom of God. Amen. Hallelujah to God. Don't let nobody fool up your head. You're walking in the Spirit, you're walking in the kingdom. My God Almighty. I said, if you're walking in the Spirit, you are walking in the kingdom. If you're walking in the Holy Ghost, you are walking in the kingdom. And we have to define what the walking in the Spirit looks like. Okay? We're going to define that as we go along in this discourse. We're going to define that, because walking in the Holy Spirit is talking about righteousness and peace and joy. These are the things that are emanating out of you. When people hear you, they're going to see, they're going to experience righteousness. They're going to see a demonstration of righteousness. They're going to see a demonstration of peace. They're going to see a demonstration of joy coming out of your life. Why? Because you are walking in the Spirit of God. Hallelujah to God. And remember, justice and all these other characteristics are also coming from the Spirit of God. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. Woo, hallelujah. I said a mouthful, all right? So righteousness, this is God's governing influence inside of us, okay? Righteousness is God's governing influence on the inside of you, okay? And that is coming from the Spirit of God, and it's telling you what is in alignment with God and what is not, all right? You know, if sin is missing the mark, sin is veering off, if sin is going off course, then righteousness is hitting the mark. Righteousness is staying on course. Righteousness is going in the direction that God has called you to be. Hallelujah, God. Righteousness is our position in Christ, and it's also our function. We are positioned in righteousness, so we function from the content of righteousness. Amen? I'm positioned in righteousness, so I function from the content of righteousness. I function from the place of righteousness, from the position of righteousness. The righteousness is not earned. It's a gift from God through Christ, okay? So your religious activities is not going to earn you righteousness. It's a gift from God. Hallelujah. It's a gift from God. So when you walk in the Spirit, and you're walking in the gift from God, because the Holy Spirit is also the gift that God has given unto man. Come on, somebody. Oh, glory to God. When God released what Christ has done, and he released the Spirit into earth, he's releasing the gift that he promised that he would release to mankind. So when you release, when you're receiving the Spirit of God, when you're receiving the Spirit of Christ, you're receiving the gift of God. Okay, so righteousness is not something that comes to you by works of your flesh. Righteousness is something that is a gift from God. Amen. Righteousness is a gift from the Almighty God. Hallelujah to God. So therefore now, righteousness also, as I said earlier, is our position in Christ, and it's also our function. So God positioned us for us to function. Because if you don't have something, you can't function from it. Amen? If you don't have righteousness, how are you going to function righteously? Okay? So that's why we have to be careful how we deal with people who are unrighteous. Because we're expecting righteousness to come out of unrighteousness, and it just doesn't work. Oh, come on. You understand what I'm saying? So we have to understand that we are positioned in righteousness so we can put on display, we can exhibit righteousness in our lives, in our mannerism, and in the way that we do what we do. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah to God. this kind of service, God says, is well pleasing unto him. Look at this. I am positioned by God in righteousness so I can function in righteousness and from true righteousness. Amen. Because there are many righteousnesses out there. The Bible said, unless your righteousness exceed that of the Pharisees and the scribe, you will not see the kingdom of God. You will not be able to access the kingdom of God. You'll not be able to come into it. Why? Because this kind of a righteousness is what man's standard of righteousness. And you can't use man's standard, oh God Almighty, to get God's kind of result, okay? You need to use God's standard in order to get the result that God requires. And you need to use God's standard in order to be acceptable unto God. You see, we're lifting up our standard to God and said, God, accept me based on my standard. God is saying, no, I can't accept you on your standard. I got to accept you on my standard. So I've gone ahead of you and prepared the way so that you can come into my standard. Glory to God. What's our problem? Just receive the standard that God has prepared. Glory to God. Receive the gift. We have it's a pride thing, you know. We have a pride thing about us. I ain't gonna take nothing. I gotta work for it. I gotta put some. No. It's not about you, because no amount of work that you do, nothing that you do will ever be enough to pay the debt of your sin. Amen. Nothing you can ever do can pay the debt of your unrighteousness and make you righteous. So God, knowing that, he put plans in place to establish his righteousness so that you can receive his righteousness and come into his rest and come into his kingdom and live a life from his righteousness. And then from that righteousness, now you can be acceptable to God. Glory to God Almighty. So God had prepared it for us. We don't want it like that. We want to do it our way. We want to do it. We want to be like Sinatra. We want to do it our way. But come on, somebody, you got to do things God's way. Amen. If God said this is the way I want it, this is the standard that I've set, we have to do it God's way. Hallelujah. Because when we do it God's way, then we are now making ourselves acceptable to God. Our service is going up to God as a sweet smelling savor. It's going up to God acceptable. Oh, glory to God. It's going up to God as a sweet aroma. And God is saying, I love that smell of righteousness coming from your life. That's a beautiful fragrance to my nostrils. I love that. That smells really good. Yo, my God, I know my wife put on certain fragrance. I'm like, woo, man. I feel like Adam again. Woo, man. Woo, God. You know, so certain fragrance, my God, it just gives you the goosebumps all over. God is saying, when you operate in my righteousness, when you operate in my righteousness, you are giving me goosebumps all over. I'm pleased and I'm satisfied when you are walking in the things that I've called you to walk in. Hallelujah to God. Glory to God. So God has prepared the righteousness for us. Why don't we just receive it and live in it and walk it and live from it and live our lives from that place? Amen. God has prepared it for us. Hallelujah to God. Oh, glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. So let's continue. I am positioned by God in righteousness so I can function in righteousness and from true righteousness, because righteousness is in my heart now, because God has placed righteousness in my heart through the releasing the Spirit of God in me, or I am righteous in my heart, it will express itself in my function, okay? It will express itself in my function, because we live based on the disposition of our heart. Out of the heart flow the issue of life. So you live based on what's disposed in your heart. So God is saying, when our disposition is righteousness, when who we are, our essence is righteousness, then we will grow into that of which we are. And then we can only express that of which we are. That's why we grow. We develop ourselves in the righteousness of God. Hallelujah to God. We develop ourselves in walking in the Spirit. We develop in ourselves in executing the kingdom of God through our lives. Amen. So these are things that we got to understand for us to be able to live the life that God called us to live. Glory to God. Oh my God, I hope you're getting this. When we serve God out of the indwelling righteousness, this is acceptable unto God. When we serve God out of the indwelling righteousness by the releasing of His Spirit into our spirit, by us receiving the Holy Spirit, God is saying that this is acceptable unto me. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Many things that we do in church and we call righteous, God is saying that is a stench to me. Many of the things, the religious things that we do, God is saying, no, that's a stench to me. That's not giving me any pleasure. I only get pleasure when you operate from the content and the context of my kingdom government. Glory to God. When we operate from the content and context of the kingdom government of God, we are bringing pleasure and we are being acceptable unto God. Come on, somebody. It's time for you and I to be acceptable unto God. It's time that we bring pleasure unto our God. Glory, glory. Because everything was created for His pleasure. Glory to God. You and I were made for His pleasure. Hallelujah to God. So we must be giving pleasure unto God. We must be giving pleasure unto God. And pleasure comes when we operate and live our lives from the place of righteousness of which we are in the new man. Glory to God. Hallelujah to God. Oh, hallelujah to God. Thank you, Jesus. When we are operating in the righteousness of God, we are under the influence of the kingdom of God, okay? When we're operating in the righteousness of God, we are under the influence of the kingdom of God. And you know how powerful influence is? You know how powerful influence is? That's why, you know, we're so against the overindulgence of alcohol, because when people indulge and overindulge in alcohol, it takes over their lives, their mind, and it now becomes their influencer, okay? It's influencing their action, it's influencing their behavior, it's influencing the things that they do. And especially we are against, as a society, when those who are under the influence of alcohol and drugs and all these different type of things go behind the wheel of an automobile, because there's so much destruction that can come out of that, because they no longer have control of their system. They are now being controlled by another spirit, because alcohol, we call it spirit, don't we? So they're influenced by another spirit. The Bible says, don't be drunk with wine wherein is excess, but for us to be filled with the Spirit of God. So don't be drunk with that spirit, come on somebody, but be filled with the Spirit of God. What God is saying, I don't want you to be influenced by any outside substance. I want you to be influenced by my Spirit. Hallelujah to God. Because my Spirit will only lead you into righteousness. Glory to God. My Spirit will only lead you into righteousness and the things which make for peace. That's where my Spirit is going to lead you. So my Spirit is not going to lead you to take another woman's, another man's husband, another man's wife, or my Spirit is not going to lead you to take another woman's husband or take another man's wife. My Spirit is not going to lead you to go cheat and to go steal and to go curse and to go lie. No, my Spirit's not going to lead you into those things. So you want to be up under the influence of my Spirit, because my Spirit is going to lead you into all truth, into all righteousness that is coming from me. And that is why it is so important, it is extremely important, that we as children of God, that we be governed by the Spirit of God. Oh, hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. That we be governed by the Spirit of God. That we be led by the Spirit of God. That we be influenced by the Spirit of God. Because when you're under His influence, you are going to be acceptable to God, and you will also be acceptable to men, those who are in the fear of God. You have to understand, some men ain't going to like you because you're walking in the Spirit. Because they want to continue in unrighteousness, and the righteousness is an exposer of unrighteousness. Am I talking to somebody? I said righteousness is an exposer of unrighteousness. Just like our light exposes what's in the dark, so righteousness exposes that which is in unrighteousness. Come on, somebody. So they may not all love you, oh God, but the government, the systems that wants to adhere to the things that makes for peace in the society, they will love you, because when the kingdom of God is executed correctly, oh my God, it will bring peace in the nation. It will, the healing will be taking place, and all these things are things that can help the society. People will be at a better state of mind, better frame of mind. That's why this world, they should not be messing with the church of the living God. Am I talking to somebody? Because I'm telling you, when people are walking in step with God, walking in righteousness with God, hallelujah to God, it also brings peace to the nation that they're a part of. Glory to God Almighty. Come on, somebody. It brings peace to the nation that they're a part of, because the people are healthier. Oh my God, because they're less stress on the people, so they're healthier. So it's going to be less stress on the system. You're going to have the hospitals be less filled with people. Hallelujah to God. Less claims, less all these different insurance claims and all these different, less of those things happening. So it takes the stress off the society and the economy when people are walking in the truth of God, in the righteousness of God. And the church is the ground and pillar of the truth of God. Don't mess with the church. Come on, somebody. I said don't mess with the church of the living God. It's for your benefit. It's for the well-being of the people. Glory to God. But if you have a government, if you have a system that don't want the people to prosper, that want to keep people in bondage, they're not going to like the church. They're not going to like the church. Oh, God have mercy. They're not going to like the people who are of the church, because the people who are of the church are going to be the ones that are going to expose the things that are in darkness. Oh, hallelujah. That's one of the characteristics of the kingdom of God. It exposes lies. It exposes the things that are hidden in darkness. It exposes the things that are covered in darkness, because light and darkness have no relationship. So when light shows up, it's going to expose what is in darkness. And light is always right. Come on, somebody say light is right, because light is in alignment with God. He is the bright light. Hallelujah to God. The Bible says when he come, he's going to be bright, shining like the sun. A matter of fact, in the Revelation, it says when he comes and set up the government influence of God on the earth, there will be no need for the sun in his territory, because the Son of Man will light that place. He is the light. Hallelujah to God. The glory of God is the light that will light Jerusalem in the name of Jesus. So when light is in order, when light is expressed, when light is manifest, darkness, people who are in darkness, who are doing things in darkness, they don't like the light. So don't worry about it. Many people are not going to like you because you're light. Come on, somebody. Hey, what you want to know, though, is that you're pleasing to God. Is that you're pleasing to God. What you want to know is that you're honoring to God. Yeah, they may want to put out your light, but don't let them put out your light. Continue to shine for the living God Almighty. Don't mess with the church of the living God. Oh, God says, I'm building my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Hey, God Almighty. So God will defend his people. God will stand for his people. God will stand for his people. He will defend his church, because the church doesn't belong to man. The church belongs to God. I said the church belongs to God. Come on, you want the church in your society. You want true godly people in your economy. You want true godly people in your company. Yeah, because they will see to it that things are run in the way that it should run. They're not going to swindle and lie and steal and cheat. When you're walking under the influence of the Spirit of God, they're going to help the company to become its best. They're going to help the society to become its best. They're going to help people to become their best. So you want to make sure you have, oh glory to God, some righteous people in the righteous, in high places, where your society is concerned, where your kingdom is concerned, where your country is concerned, where your economy is concerned, where your company is concerned. You want to have some righteous people. Don't kill them. Don't so that the darkness that is hindering the progress of your company, oh my God Almighty, there's darkness that is hindering the progress of your company. And if you have people that are shining light in these dark places, it will expose the things that are being a hindrance to the progress of where you want to be. Come on, somebody. Don't mess with the church of the living God. Hey, don't mess with the church of the living God. Look at this. Look at this. Hallelujah to God. I'm closing. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, God. We'll pick this up another time. Acts chapter 5, 40 and 20. The apostles were executing the righteousness of God. They were going about and they were preaching and teaching the things of the gospel and the kingdom of God, the things of Christ, the things that Christ had told them to speak about. They were teaching these things. They were teaching the kingdom of God. And as they were going about teaching and preaching this new so-called doctrine, the Pharisaical leadership calls it, they're filling Jerusalem with this new doctrine. Look what happened to them. They were called into questioning, and they were being questioned for doing the thing that God has called them to do. And look what happened. Verse 40, let me read from there. And to him they agreed, meaning this was this high priest that was making a declaration, and he was saying that don't mess with these people, because if they're of God, you will find yourself fighting against God, and you do not want to fight against Jesus. You do not want to fight against God. And he said that if they're not of God, come on, then this thing is not going to last. It's not going to be sustainable. Remember the other guy who rose up and look what happened to him. You know, so don't worry yourself over it. But if it's of God, you want to make sure you don't find yourself fighting against God. And they agreed to that. And when they had called the apostles in, look what happened. Because you're walking in the Spirit, walking in righteousness, and beaten them. They were beaten. Oh, Lord of mercy. They were beaten. They commanded that they should not speak. They should not speak in the name of Jesus, and let them go. They should not speak in the name of Jesus. So you see that there's an attack against the name of Jesus. They don't want the name of Jesus in the society. Oh God, they take us out of the school. They take us out of the parliament. They're taking us out of all these different places because they don't want the name of Jesus in this environment. Not understanding that the name of Jesus is victory for them. The name of Jesus is victory for them. Hallelujah. To God. It's victory for them, but they did not want it. And they beat them and sent them out. And look what happened, verse 41. And they departed from the presence of the council, rejoicing that they were counted worthy to suffer shame for his name. They were suffering shame. They beat them and dragged them out, and they were suffering shame for the name of Jesus. But they didn't worry about that. Look what they did in verse 42. And daily in the temple and in every house, they ceased not to teach and preach Jesus Christ. In other words, they punished them or tell them not to do these things, but they went right back to what God had called them to do. Because you can't let nobody stop you, no counsel stop you from doing what God has called you to do. As long as what you're doing is in righteousness, as long as what you're doing is the promotion of peace, hallelujah to God, from God's perspective. And oh